I just made it to middle of nowhere, Idaho. I have no clue where I'm at in this state. It feels like somewhere in the center. Just met up with Joe, who took this awesome buck. Hold that. That's his this year's 2016 buck. Look at that thing. Oh man. Oh, yeah. Couple cheaters, big old frame, dark antlers. I would love to see a buck like that in a hunting situation. I'm here in Idaho because I have a non-resident Idaho rifle tag. Joe said he can show me around.
I'll show you around. You can find something.
Get to where we're hunting tonight and just try to take a little bit of a look at the land. I like to see the terrain, but our plan for the next two and a half days is just to glass as much country and as many deer as we can. Hopefully find a shooter, so let's go. This is the hunting rig, huh?
1 year older than me.
Your first truck?
Oh yeah.
Man, you gotta love your first vehicle. That's cool that it still runs. We got plenty of room for our gear. Welcome to 1990, guys.
Clean, one owner.
Clean title, one owner, original miles.
Oh yeah.
I love an old truck, you know. It's something fun just about having a truck that you really don't care if he just gets beat up or scratched. You can use it on the mountain.
I'd hope it's striping.
It looks like you did upgrade to the JVC.
Yeah, but as you can see, it doesn't work.
No buttons working on that. Well, for those of you who have never been to central Idaho, welcome to the high country. The beautiful skyscape, and I'm pretty sure I drove from Salt Lake with both windows down this morning straight into winter. It is cold. We just got up here. There's probably four inches of snow or so right where we're at, but we're gonna set up to just glass the evening. We don't have a lot of time, but we can see a lot of country, and with this new skiff of snow, I think it's gonna be really easy. Make it easy to see the deer a lot easier.
We'll find something, that's for sure.
He's got a Vortex, I got a Vortex. We both got binos, both got scopes, both got phone scopes. We're gonna find something. Well, we are headed off this mountain back to not as cold weather, which will be great because my hands are freezing. We had a good night. We didn't have a lot of time to glass, but we did turn up a small buck and a doe. Tomorrow we'll have a lot more time. We'll have a lot more daylight, and we're gonna put some miles on the boots, right?
Oh yeah.
What do we got? What do we got?
Fresh wolf track.
And it's wait. Yeah, he said a wolf track. Show us.
It's fresh. It's not frozen.
That's not a beer.
Yeah. There's a better one right there.
See that point up there? We're headed to that point. We're going to glass. We're going to see a lot of deer. It's going to be good. We made it to this peak. There's a deer coming out below. Check her out. Another doe. So, this is not technically opening day, but to me it feels like opening day of the Idaho hunt. We hiked for about an hour and 20 minutes straight up from the bottom of the creek. We're just finally getting up here where we can see really good. We can hear elk bugling. We saw wolf tracks. We've already seen a handful of does. So me and Joe are just gonna pick this apart.
Yeah. Fingers crossed.
Sun's up. Our first little glassing spot was successful.
Decent four, but not what we're after.
Yeah, two decent bucks, like middle-aged class bucks. They're both following all the does. It's pretty funny. It's not quite the rut, but they're getting excited, I think. Joe's making me run up this mountain. I'm not used to this. I just came from the flat land. But we're gonna get to another high point in glass. Like we have to take advantage of first light and glass as much country as we can. So on the trail we go.
Let's do this.
Let's go. Come here, right here.
Stand right there by that tree. Okay. That's him.
Are you sure?
Yep, that's him. That's him.
Make sure to watch that camera.
For sure? Yeah, that's him. Yeah, holding, he's behind the tree. He's gonna walk out.
Whistle.
Brap. Brap.
Jumped. He's gonna stop.
He can't fly now.
He just went over.
I'm really bummed. Super bummed right now. We came off that hill and spotted him right there. He did not look hit and he started running. And the way he was running and moving his legs, didn't look hit at all. Never could really stop on this open for a clear shot. But just to make sure, Joe and I are gonna walk over here to where he was standing, where I thought I hit him, which maybe he just jumped, I don't know. We're gonna go double check his tracks and check for blood. If there's no blood, then I'm 100% confident that he's not hit, because you can see in the video, I mean, he's tearing out of there and he doesn't have a limp or anything. I'm so bummed. I mean, this is hunting and that was awesome. I had a lot of fun, but man, I'm always rushed. You know, I did have my bipod out and stuff, but I just wish I can get one of these times where we can set up the camera, get the phone scope, and do it that way, but maybe later, huh?
Yeah, hopefully.
Guys, we just found the buck I shot and missed. Definitely not hit. He's covered a lot of ground. He's walking just fine. He's a big 3-point frame buck with cheaters. Oh man, I would love to get that buck, but he's working his way up this hill. We're gonna keep an eye on him. If we can, we're gonna bed him. Fingers crossed that he just lays down and beds, but I think he's gonna go over the next ridge. I just have a feeling he wants to get over that. Got the phone scope on him. Right there. Alright guys, let's see if we can bed him and make this happen somehow. There he goes, dude. My dream buck gone. What do you think?
That was a sweet buck, man. We're gonna kill him, bro.
He's so far away. I'm just glad we saw him.
Yeah. I just wish he would have bedded down.
I know. He's on a mission out of here.
He's definitely an old buck.
Yeah.
He knows where he's going.
Mm-hmm. Dang it. Such a sweet buck.
I know.
Gosh. Got some phone scope footage of him, though. I really, really... We were wondering if he was a 3x4 frame, but he's a 3x3 frame. My dream buck.
Yeah.
With cheaters.
Exactly what you wanted, too.
I told you.
Told me last night, I just wanted a nice 3-point with kickers.
Mm-hmm.
And we found one.
That's insane.
Now we just need to get it done.
All right, we're going to keep an eye out for him, guys. Back to the hunt.
Yep, there we go. There, he just bedded down.
Yes!
Oh my god.
Perfect spot. Dude, what just happened, man?
We just bedded down a buck.
The buck.
He came out right where that cheater buck just came out of.
This is the cheater buck, dude.
It is?
This is the buck.
You think?
I know so. Guys, we just bedded the buck I missed. He worked his way so far away, it's not even funny. And he was walking up this open drainage, and I kept telling Joe, I just want him to bed. He kicked out of bed. Right when he stopped, I was like, he's going to kick out of bed, and he did. So now we have the buck bedded, and I'm confident it was him. I thought for sure it was.
That is him.
I thought it was for sure it's him.
It's him.
Guys, this is a dream buck for me, a big 3-point frame with cheaters. And now we have him bedded in the wide open. Got a long ways to go, guys. Probably the most important thing, not spook other deer his way. We're gonna take you guys with us. We're gonna have cameras rolling. Hopefully we can do a bedded shot, but hope you guys are enjoying this as much as me, because this is fun. Miss a buck, track him down, give him a second chance, hopefully. we made it to where we can see and where we thought we would be able to get a shot, but the buck is not there anymore. He might have moved and changed beds, or we busted some deer that got him up and moved him, so we don't know where he's at right now. We think he could be close, but he can also be blown out of here with those does getting nervous, who knows. We did such a good job to dodge all the deer, and then at the last second, five does got up and went right his direction. We're not sure if they went to him or not. Dang it. This is hunting, man. Highs, lows. What'd you find?
See anything?
Nope. Sweet.
Not a bad shed.
Pretty shape.
Yeah.
That's cool. We never could see that buck. Figured we'd come down here to where he was bedded. Try to figure out which direction he went. There's a fresh track going that way.
Going down?
Yeah, that's him. Here's where he was bedded. Got up.
This way.
Down. Dang it. He's probably somewhere in that mess right now, but I think I'm gonna follow his tracks for a little while. See where he went down and then glass the other side. Well, Joe just made the spot of the season. He found some deer. Remember we went and saw that the tracks were going downhill. So we glassed across into this steep, rugged country. It's got that hillside is burnt. And Joe found some bucks. He found a buck with some does. And he's like, dude, another buck bedded. We are like 95% sure it's the buck I missed and the buck that was right here. I mean, he's got the same 3-point frame with eye guards, yeah. Big swoops. The way he's going right now, we can't tell that he's got cheaters or not. Either way, he's a big, old, mature buck, 3-point frame.
Bladed.
We're guessing it's the same buck. I mean, it's so similar, it's unreal. So we got to go all the way down. Get down into the flat by the creek bed, go all the way up the steep spine. Super rocky over there, and once we get over there, we just need to find him, but we're gonna be close, way close.
Yeah, like 200 yards, I bet.
Here we go, dude. Fingers crossed. Good spot, buddy.
So we just hauled down here, like real fast. I saw Joe took a spill, maybe two.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take a layer off and get some mountain hops and see that hill up there, the skyline. That's where we're going. That's where the big buck is.
It's gonna be steep.
It's gonna be steep. This is crazy, guys. We've only been hunting one day. This is one day. Well, not even a full day, but we've probably put in about 4 days worth of work on
it. Yeah.
I mean, we've been on 2 successful stalks, you know, got a shot. Now we're heading up there to hopefully seal the deal. You hear that?
Oh yeah.
Swallow like a horse. Okay,
this is steep. Definitely the hardest I've worked on a hunt in a long time. I'm out of breath, begging Joe for food. Luckily he gave me some food, I'm feeling better, but drink some mountain hops. That helped too. I didn't drink much water because it's so cold. But we're getting close. Gotta go up there.
Well, I came over the top to see if he still bedded there, and he knew something wasn't right. The does were above him looking at him.
They were nervous.
Yeah, they were real nervous, and that big 3-point just started working his way through chaparral.
Yeah.
Just working through that, and then there's a smaller buck. Luckily, you noticed that.
Dude,
it was a small
buck. Had the crosshairs, and I was like, that's a smaller buck.
Yeah.
He was narrow, and I shot. Well, the big buck came out, and he was trying to stop him. I shot and missed that shot, and then they were working up through some yellow brush, and Joe made a good decision to come, like, literally rock scaling.
Yeah.
Look how steep this is. This is insane. And I got on this dead rest right here. And he's all, be patient. I'm like, I mean, I about pulled the trigger. I was like, all right, I got to be patient. And that buck came out in the smallest clearing.
Yeah.
Because I saw the does go through it, and then he came through it. Boom. Trump. Guys, when you shoot something with a rifle, you hear the thud. I heard the thud, baby. We got it. We got
finally
it.
Finally did it, dude. Oh. First day of the hunt, man.
Yeah, first day. This was one heck of a hunt. He dropped in his tracks. When I hit him, he can hear the thud, and I was just like, I couldn't believe it, and I told him, I was like, it ain't over yet, dude. Let's make sure. So we have been watching him. I can see his rear end, and he hasn't budged. Finally, the Weatherby and the Vortex got a deer down. It took me a few shots, I'm not going to lie. I shot right through there. See his white rump? That window I shot through and dropped him in his tracks. He hasn't moved. There he is. Like I said, we're not sure if it's the same cheater buck or not. I don't think it is, to be honest with you. But it's a stud.
Big three.
Big three. Look at that thing. He's all bladed out, dude. No cheaters. Twinsies.
Oh yeah.
Dude, that's so cool, guys. There's this buck and the other buck we hunted. Dang things are like twins, except yeah. The other one had cheaters.
Dude, they're but identical.
I've been saying, I want to get a big 3-point buck with front forks. Check that off the bucket list. What a stud. He's all heavy and stubbed up. Dang. Wow, dude, that's insane. Is it he broke or just bladed?
I think he broke it fighting, maybe.
Oh, his horns are so heavy. Dude, look at his neck. Beautiful, beautiful buck. Look at the mass on the blades. His neck is so big. Look at the neck.
Yeah.
That's an old buck, man. That was really my goal, is to get an old mature buck on this hunt. Mission accomplished. Wow, beautiful buck. Oh, thank you, buddy. How cool. Gorgeous cape, man.
Yeah.
Look at the size of him. Guys, thank you for joining us on this hunt. I know that was a long day. Hope you enjoyed it. We put a lot of extra effort into filming. Unfortunately, didn't get the kill shot, but I don't think that matters.
No.
This is what matters, that we got it done. Dude, that's so heavy over there.
Yeah, I know.
Bladed out. Everything is just so thick.
He's an old buck. That's
yeah, he's an old buck.
Short, stubby nose.
Yeah, how cool, dude. Thanks for your help, man.
No problem, man.
Good spot, too. Spot of the century.
Yeah.
I want to give you a look at this thing. The body and head on this deer is probably the biggest I've ever taken. Look at that size of that thing. It's pre-rut, so he's got all his, you know, summer weight, summer fat, but he hasn't quite lost all his rut weight. Because the rut hasn't started yet. Look at that. He is such a pretty buck. His cape, his big white face. When Joe spotted him, we could tell he had a big old white face. The rifle did its job. I finally did mine and put it on the money, and we got it done. We got a lot of work now, though.
Oh, yeah.
So we're going to get to working on this guy, guys. Well, guys, we are back where we started. Joe's house, his garage with his big old buck. That got me super excited to hunt out here and motivated to hunt out here. And we just drove off the mountain. It frosted last night and froze all the meat. We have everything taken care of. We're just gonna load up the meat in the Yeti cooler for the ride home. Go get a bag of ice and it's over. But that was fun.
Oh yeah, that's a blast.
Had a blast.
Can't wait till next year.
Yeah, next year. I'm gonna try to book a hunt again next year. Had so much fun. Only got to hunt one day, but man, like I said earlier, we put in about 4 days worth of work. But I'd love to get back on those ridges again and do it all over. Now that we're rested up, it sounds like a lot of fun. Didn't sound like fun last night.
No.
Pretty cool. Thanks again, man.
Yeah, no problem.
All right, guys. Year. Gonna wrap it up. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe.